a la República Dominicana, la casa del merengue y la casa de la bachata. Voy a cantar esta canción.
Okay.
Con mucho cariño de mi corazón.
I can't discriminate about the music in Spanish, you know. It's free YouTube music, I'll take it. Welcome to the night show. Late starting as always, because I'm just late tonight. I'm late tonight. I'm going to name my nickname Late for Dinner tonight. That's what it is. I'm just going to pick up where I left off. Tomorrow is an off day from work, so I'll be drawing tomorrow. And therefore, we'll have a better show tomorrow night. Oh boy. Gotta find my. There it is. Man. Uh oh. What's going on with my. Okay, that's weird. I gotta do audio check. Hold on 1 second. Audio check. Audio check. Test, test, test. I'm gonna kill some of this music though. It's a little loud. Let's see. Let's just do that. That might do the trick, or it won't. I don't know. But we're underway. We're drawing. Quick little update on tonight's plan. I am gonna take a break at some point to go put coffee in my cup. It's brewing right now. But I felt like I didn't want to wait any longer because I'm only going to draw or paint a little bit tonight. I'm kind of, not that I'm not in the mood, but, you know, I just want to have more time in front of the computer than a little bit. And so I don't get much work done during these sessions, not any real work. And having me just sit here in silence for 5 hours just doesn't do it for me. So, yeah. Gonna draw some tree stuff. Alright, so what I want to draw is this other tree, or paint this other tree on the right hand side of the image. This bad boy over here. But we're gonna do it by the numbers. I gotta ink first. So this might be a good 45 minutes to an hour. I don't know, because I want to ink first, but I might actually do it in reverse so I can get more coverage. Is go ahead and let's see here. What am I working with? Start off a little rough, but actually I want to zoom way in there. Let's zoom way in there. And then where's my navigator? There we go. So I can see what's going on in here. And we're gonna find one of these plants, and let's find this one. We're just gonna do is we'll just kind of use the basic outline and just do plant life like this and just kind of fill that bad boy out like that, you know. I guess these are flowers. Sorry, I said plants, but I mean the whole tree is a plant, not these little plants. Like, yeah, don't mind me. I'm tired. But this will be fun. This will be fun. I'm drawing. It's fun. Enjoy it. Shit. Actually, I had a really good day at work today. You know, the commute home wasn't so bad. I got home in only an hour and a half, you know, from work, which wasn't bad. And then, like, I got a chance to play some Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic, and eat dinner while it was still light outside, which is nice. You know, so today was a pretty chill day. So I'm in a good mood. I'm just a little tired. A little tired. And I like this mic, but the only thing I don't like is it's a headset, not really a mic. It's like for gaming, really, more than it is for broadcasting. But the volume control doesn't have a clip, and it's kind of heavy. So if I move, it like drops, and I think I just destroyed it. It's a little like, so I have to hold it like Spider-Man. Like I'm holding on to like a little piece of it, which is kind of cool because I always like feeling like Spider-Man, which is rare because I'm kind of chubby. And Spider-Man's only like chubby in Earth-X, and that's like way in the future. But I think he's like a cop eventually. After I think Luke Cage convinces him to do the cop thing. I forget. Somehow. Maybe not. Maybe he's not a cop. I don't know. But that's a big ass flower. I think I need to tone that flower down. It's okay though. We'll get bigger flowers and smaller flowers. There's one over here. I used the, created a brush to create these flowers in the pencil phase. So, yeah. I'm really kind of just finding those centers of the brush pattern. And then there we go. And I kind of see how I made that one a little off because I want it to look like it's not just a flat thing. And also I realized almost immediately that I didn't want to do the brush thing again because it'll be more fun. It'll look more vibrant and real if each little petal is slightly off a little bit. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, B? The footage from, I guess that'd be Friday or Thursday, is in YouTube. Like, it's not published, but it's there. And so I'm probably going to use that footage, if I haven't already, for like tomorrow night show. And then the footage from tomorrow's day, like day of drawing, I'll put that on like the following night show or whatever like that. I'll use that footage when I'm doing something where I want to do more explaining and less drawing, possibly. My YouTube channel, I've neglected it a little bit with the work and stuff like that. But every time I don't feel like getting my draw on, all it takes is forcing myself to open up the program and get started, and then all of a sudden here I am drawing and happy trees, my people. Happy trees. Just a little, man, I want to turn the opacity up a little bit so I can get a better sense of where all the my leaf petals are, but then again, kind of like how it's coming out so far. I gotta find some more Star Wars books on tape, man. I'm not sure which one to listen to next, but the other day I got a lot of drawing done, and I listened to a Star Wars book on tape, a book that I had already actually read, like the book version of it. And I want to go back and read the damn book again, because there was one section of the book that stuck with me like above all else, but I did not hear it in the, you know, in the audio version, and I think it was the part of the prologue, and so they may have done away with it for like pacing and stuff. I don't know, but it's like this section that describes what it's like to see Darth Vader run amok on a battlefield, and I felt like there was a whole section that just didn't make it into the audiobook that I could totally be wrong about, which I feel is concerning for reasons that have nothing to do with like Star Wars geekiness. Just, is my memory that bad? I mean, I read that book. That scares the crap out of me to think I like missed so much of it. This is just one of the reasons I wanted to redo this in this fashion, is because I didn't like all that darkness. It was just the brush stuck to the page, and I was just I was tired and I was in a hurry, and I was like, you know, I can fix this in post, essentially. That's why I love Photoshop, because it still gives me a template, even if the idea was something totally different. But yeah, after I did this page last week, I went outside and said, I don't have enough leaves on my tree. Like not enough at all. So I do have some ideas for getting more green and more leaves onto the tree without spending another entire day drawing leaves. Let's zoom out and see how this looks. Those are big, but I like that. Actually, I'm gonna leave it right here too, because now that I have a, I can now adjust the size a little bit more. Also, I hurt my index finger, and I don't know how. I gotta squeeze the pus out. I know that sounds gross, but it happens every once in a while, and it starts to really hurt, like around the cuticle. And it's just basically I gotta hold my finger in hot water until it relaxes, for lack of a better term, and then I gotta squeeze the pus out of the cuticle, and it'll stop hurting. I'm just procrastinating about doing it, which is strange, but it's really uncomfortable. I don't know. I think it may be from squeezing so hard or so much on the pencil. Twitch told me to put hashtags in my title. I'm not thrilled about why they're there in all of all places. I gotta look up the FAQ and see if I'm in the, put them in the right place. Like, it's just like, @DanteMaddox, #comics, #painting, #Photoshop, #excitement. No, it doesn't say #excitement, but it should. It's exciting stuff. You guys missed it earlier when I was playing Star Wars and streaming. A beetle knocked on the door, and I mean that in the most literal sense possible. The beetle was huge for a beetle. It was the size of a hummingbird, easily. I thought it was a hummingbird at first, because the way their wings flap at such a speed, you know? And basically, the one dog that was not in the living room was in here with me. And there was a rapping at the door, and my mom assumed it was the dog, you know. And so she knocked on, she opened the door to see if it was the dog. I'm like, how'd you get outside in the first place? And that motherfucker just came in. He was like, and bogarted in. And beetles are beautiful, but they are belligerent and horrible at flying. Like, I don't understand what the point of that shit is. Like, he's terrible at it. He needs to get a bus pass or an Uber or something. It's awful. And he just, like, he could not, like, land. He was like, I need to set down over here, but I can only crash. It's the only thing I know how to do is crash. And he just kept smacking into the wall. And after a while, I was just kind of sad. You know, you're like, oh, that's so funny. That's got to hurt. Wait, he needs help, a hug, a doctor, something. Because this motherfucker is about to die. Like, he even got bit by my dog. My dog, he fell to the ground, and the dog bit him. My mom was like, oh, and tried to, like, choke the dog, nearly spit the beetle out. And eventually he did, because Nathan is an asshole. And, he just bit the beetle as soon as the beetle came within, like, biting distance. And we were like, damn it, Nathan, because that's his actual name. You know, his collar and whatever says Nathan, but his name is like, you motherfucker. I'm like, god damn, like, that's his actual name. God damn it is his name. What the hell is wrong with you? That's his name. Like, last night, motherfucker climbed up on the table, just in there, running him up while I was in here. Oh, mother, oh, pisses me off. And then you try to be all cute, like, oh, I'm just playing. No, you wasn't playing, you bastard. And he might be. I mean, I know where his mama is. Oh, motherfucker. Man. But yeah. Nathan bit his ass and then spit him out, and he was still alive, and he flew around some more, like, alright, I can see what I'm not wanting, I'm gonna leave here. As soon as I find the door, he found every wall except the door. He smacked into everything. He could hear it. He was huge. As big as a damn dragonfly, or hummingbird. Just hit every surface, smacked him until he fell into the dog's food dish, which was like, maybe he's suicidal. Maybe he's had enough. He's like, if the dog's gonna eat me, the dog's just gonna eat me. Shit. And so we had to scoop him out the dog food dish and throw him out. But yeah, that was kind of exciting. Because my mom was like, dude, I need you to come in here. Something's in the house. I'm not sure what it is. And the way she said it, I thought it was going to be like a something with four legs, like alive, like a rodent or some sort. I'm like, how did something like that get in the house? And the dogs didn't immediately destroy it, because they are not fucking around. My dog will lose his shit if he sees a squirrel outside. He'd be like, look, you need to let me out of here right now, because that motherfucker needs to die. And I'm like, no, I can't have that squirrel's death on my conscience. You are too enthusiastic about going out there and fucking him up. What did he do that was so awful? And he's like, I don't know. It's instinctual. It's somewhere in my guts. I feel that I got to go out there and bite that shit out of that mom. Because we won't know what's going on. We'll be in the living room watching TV, and he will just go apeshit all of a sudden. Like, it's 4th of July, and it's fireworks everywhere. We're like, buddy, dude, what the fuck, man? And he's like, just whining and howling and barking and just, and we look outside like maybe it's like all the mailmen or something, and it's nothing. And I'm looking like, okay, it's more concerning to me that there's nothing out there. If it was like a cat or something, I would feel better. Like, okay, at least he's just barking at the normal shit, but I don't see nothing. And I'm like, buddy, do we take you to the doctor to make sure everything's okay, my man? Because I don't see nothing out there. And a couple minutes go by, now I'm curious. Now I'm sitting there, now I'm invested. And he's just like whining and whimpering, like the worst thing has happened. Like Jason is hiding behind the bushes out there with the machete. Like if you let me out there right now, we're all gonna die. I'm like, hold on, buddy, hold on, you know. And then finally something will rustle in the grass. And it's a damn squirrel. You are over here losing your mind because you can't go out there and fight that squirrel to the death. Knowing that squirrel will probably win. Yeah, buddy's adorable. He ain't no tough dog. He makes me nervous. He be game, and then it's like, nah, that dog will fuck you up, buddy. You know it. I know it. The other dog knows it. You shut the fuck up. Come on, let's go. Yeah, but he, man, squirrels. It's a different story. I don't think I could keep him from, like, I mean, he would try and pull away and drag me down the street. If he was strong enough, he would do it to get a squirrel. I've seen him under a tree, like, you gotta come down sometime, motherfucker. And the squirrel's like, no, technically I don't. I ain't gotta come down at all. I'll go to this other tree over here and throw nuts at you. You know, but hey, dogs will be dogs, I guess. Alright, we can come along with these flowers. And then we're gonna, once the flowers are done, I'll put in some tree, some branch. I'm so glad I got the age gate up. It's like, he's gonna be cursing on this thing. That's right. I can't sit here and do my own thing and to watch my language. That's some bullshit, man. Fuck all that. You know? Even though the comic books are technically for like all ages, there's no cursing in the comic books itself. You know, so, but everything I do has an age gate. Like, there's some inappropriate language. You know, this is not for children to watch, unfortunately. I probably could edit together some video where I take out, well, you know what though? I got the super speed fast motion ones where there's no talking at all, just music and quick art. I can probably get the age gate removed from those, but I don't know, man. Like, I'm anti-censorship for sure. I think it makes us stupid because we forget to establish intent. We just go with magic words instead. And we're listening for magic words instead of listening to what people are trying to say to us. It makes us dull. And I don't mean boring. I mean literally, like, blunted. Because we're listening for keywords in regular conversation with people right in front of us. That's a damn shame. Fuck that song. Should be paying attention. This music is nice. Oh, I jinxed it. Now they're gonna play some weird shit. Okay. What kind of flowers are these? The kind with petals. Leave me alone. I'll slap the shit out of you. No, I won't. But I will draw more of these flowers. Because remember, most of the plants are artificial on this planet, you know, so I'm just having fun making up plants. Hey, another viewer showed up. Welcome, welcome, viewer. I don't know how long you've been there, but I'm glad you showed up. Thank you very much. It's Monday. I don't typically have a ton of viewers on Monday. The most of viewers I'll have are around 6 or so, which is exponentially more than when I was on YouTube. Because, you know, it hovered around a steady, constant 0. Significant amount of zeros there. Okay, and now that I'm ready to start drawing the wood, I am actually going to take a quick short commercial break with no commercials to get some coffee. And then when I come back, I'm going to do a little leaf action to go along with the flowers, I think, and then do the wood from the tree. And maybe if time permits, I'll do some painting. It might just be inks tonight and then paints tomorrow. And I'll work on something else throughout the day and do this live. It may be that page 18 is the live show until page 18 is done, and then I just do other pages as I... Good evening, Joker's Maze. How's it going, man? I'll be back in just 1 second. I'll put a be right back message. I don't have a... I can probably make one, but... I'm just gonna swing over here to... And be back in just... Uno momento. Okay. All right. And we're back. Oh boy. I'm not sure which program I'm going to upgrade first. Is it going to be my XSplit for the show or the other broadcaster for the gaming? I think the show is so much more relaxed. I actually don't need to upgrade quite yet. And the gaming one might be more, I don't know, immediately beneficial. We shall see. But these leaves here give me an idea. So let's see where I'm drawing here. Where am I drawing? I'm drawing here. So let's call this flowers. And I really hope that it's gonna switch the scene. How bad is the delay here? Come on now. Show me the people. Okay. Wow, does it not work? Is it? I mean, okay, it's there. It is. That took all of the time. All right, cool. All right, so yeah, I made a layer called flowers. Nothing else yet. And we're gonna put this. Okay, that's another panel. So we're gonna go flowers panel two. Okay, and then we're gonna make a new layer and call this leaves panel two. Now I gotta be careful because I'm realizing, you know, yeah, I'll be careful. Only because these are gonna be bunched together and probably gonna get inked into either a really, really dark green or just straight up black. So in this section at the bottom where you can see these dark, like, you know, clouds, or not dark, like the big dark sections, we're just gonna start throwing in some leaves, just small leaves. Just sort of fill out this little dark area with leaves. So, Joker's Maids, if this is your first time checking out the stream, I hope you like what you see. If any comments and stuff, I welcome them. A few people hop on who I've met through either gaming or doing this, who come on and talk to me while I work, and it's really nice. So, feel free to make any comment you want. I will respond as soon as I look over to the left to see what's going on over there. Especially if you have any kind of tips about making your or making my Twitch channel better. Like, I got a lot of help from some of the other people who checked out my broadcast, who helped me kind of do little things here and there to make my channel a little bit better. I'd like the channel to be nice. Oh, cool. Nice. That's nice. Before you go, I will try and share your, like, you know, here, I'll do it now while I'm still here. And that way, if I catch you doing your thing online, I will, I think it's called hosting. Someone did it for me, and I think that's pretty cool. You can do that, so I'll figure out how to do it. And if I get a chance, I'll do that. Like, I'll host, and so people can see what you're doing more. I think it's how that works. I'm not quite sure, but that's cool that you're drawn at the same time. That's cool. Oh, that's cool. Okay. I will not pry. But I will admit to feeling a tad bit intimidated all of a sudden. That's okay, though. On my YouTube channel, I have a whole thing about how I'm like not doing tutorials. I'm not a Photoshop expert, but I feel like I've been making that claim enough to where, you know, if someone says something, then I'll be like, oh, wait, I'm not an expert. I'm just out here doing my best. Give this a little bit of a trail so that I don't have to go through every single inch. You know, these, they look less like leaves, more like berries at this point, but they'll be green. So, but what I'll do is I'll make them a really, really dark green. I'm not going to ink them black because I'll lose the black lines and it won't make any sense. So yeah, they'll be like a really dark, dark green. Once I move up and like kind of give it a couple of different like paths of green leaves, I'll put my branches in and then we'll look at the time and decide if we're gonna paint tonight or if we're gonna just cut it bare. For the other trees, the ones that just need more leaves, I'm thinking about like trying to save time but get that exact same color and everything that I already have there. And so what I'm thinking about doing, because I don't think I can make a brush that's multicolored like that. It would be like a black and white brush and I still have to paint, and at that point I wouldn't want to do it that way. I just want to do it from scratch if that was going to do all that. So what I'm thinking about doing is open up another document and painting like a branch or two with all the leaves I think should be there. And then just copying it over and over again, like grabbing it and moving it over and over again. Because each time you move it over, it'll start its own layer. And so I'll just keep placing it, and then I'll warp the layers and a bunch of other stuff to kind of give each branch its own uniqueness. And then I'll just merge them all, and those will be my leaves. And they should look slightly different. I don't know. I think I have to test it and see how that works. But these two trees took roughly 6 hours, which is great and good, but I got like an 8 hour a day job, man, and 6 hours on two panels on one page is like, ouch. So I gotta figure out a way to be more efficient for my foliage. I like the finished product, but the time amount it took to get to that point is rough on me. Oh, thanks. I hope this... For some reason lately, Twitch has been, like, not liking my chat. And I keep getting this thing where it looks like my chat is frozen. And then if I refresh the page, I lose the chat. Like, and I can't tell who's actually... I know people are on, but I can't tell who's chatting or who's who. It just says I have a certain number of viewers. So I'm gonna leave it alone. And if it does that working symbol for too long, I'm just going to chalk it up to technical difficulties. But yeah, not to offend, but the leaves on that bush, plant, tree, whatever, all look the same. The one I'm, let's see, have you considered copy-pasting the line art of those leaves for the rest of the plant? Do you mean the one I'm working on currently, or the painted, the green ones? There's a delay. Let me take out that layer, so maybe it won't look so the same. Let's see here. Does that look better? Here it comes. Oh yeah, my voice also delayed. Oh, copy and paste the line art. I see. That would be faster. That would be faster. I'm almost done with the bunches of leaves. And I think I have too many bunches of leaves. Now that I think about it, I feel like this may have gotten away from me just a little bit. That's why I'm looking at my other screen, not my actual screen. Okay, let's see here. I see what he's saying. That does make a lot of sense. So, well, let's take a look at this again. Let's put that back. All right, because that's like the amount of fullness I want, right? Hold that thought, because that's a good idea. Let me throw on one more layer and put my branches in so I can get a better look at it. And then if I can do that, I'll have the layer all by itself. I can easily copy and paste. Oh, cool. I'm guessing you probably can't tell me which one, which I totally understand. Fair enough. Fair enough. I'm in that if I become successful boat myself. I'm not successful as a comic book artist. Not quite yet. It'd be nice though. I figure if I can get a couple of these books out in print and see where it goes from there, and we'll see where it goes from there. Let's see. There is some detail on my DeviantArt page. I think if you are on the Twitter feed, you can see, like, my YouTube channel, my DeviantArt, of course my Twitter account, and then I have a fledgling Patreon account that it doesn't really do its thing. I don't really know how to use Patreon quite yet. But DeviantArt has some details there as far as the comic, and also previous episodes of this show, because this is like episode like 11 or 12, you can see them on my YouTube channel, and I do talk about the story of the comic book. It's a little well, not complicated. I mean, most stories are have some level of complication or complexity. This is the first issue of a 12-issue series that will be considered book one. So, book one is how the, well, long story short, it's a superhero independent comic, which I've read. It is a huge no-no. There's just no real point in doing superhero comic books as independent, but I write superhero stories, and so there I am, you know. So the first series is called MPD or Metro PD, and it's sort of people who are superpowered who end up becoming police officers. It's a long story, no pun intended, or maybe intended, I don't know. But it's sort of a world building exercise where at the end of it all, I want to have a comic book universe with, you know, fantastic characters and capes and tights, but I wanted to show how it came to that. And so there's a whole thing about the premise of the story and all the other parts of it. And so it is a long story. It's basically the world is different from our own, and the transition from the world we know and the world in the comic books starts at the Renaissance. But even though this story doesn't go back that far as what the reader sees, but that is the history of the world. And this issue I'm working on is a special edition, which was the gift people got if they helped me get the monitor I'm working on. So, it's the first issue of Metro PD, and I'm gonna make it and then give it to the people who contribute to my GoFundMe account for free. The only thing different is the cover is unique, and it doesn't have the backup stories. So when the actual first issue comes out, and the books are sized for like the same size as a manga book, even though they're not manga, and then they'll be available for free digitally as well. Like, I would, if I could figure out how to give my comic books away for free and somehow turn a profit through some other means, I would do it. But, you know, that's kind of a pipe dream. So basically, I would like to make the book available for free, and I will, on my Facebook page. And then after you read the book for free, if you want your own physical print copy, there'll be a link to go to Amazon to, you know, buy a copy of the book. And I hope that works out for me. It may not. I mean, who knows? If I'm giving it away for free, someone may not want a copy they can hold in their hands after they read it. But if I figure if I do the book well and it's good, then someone might go, man, I really want to hold one of these. And then there you go. And then they'll be available on Kindle for like 99 cents. I can go that cheap on Kindle no matter how big or dense the book is. For comics, for this many pages, I think I can probably get away with selling this on Amazon for about $3, maybe. I'm not sure. It'll be as cheap as possible, but, you know, again, we shall see. I feel like I'm probably about 2 or 3 weeks away from at least sending out for the first prints to see how the colors and stuff look in live paper, you know. And I will probably have another, not quite sure after that, until like I'm ready to start mailing out copies to people. Sites like Tapister. I may write that down. I know about Kaboom or Kabloom. I think it's Kaboom. And but my next project is a graphic novel, and that's going to be regular size, and I can't do that on CreateSpace. And so I do need another medium. So Tapastic. Okay. I'll definitely check that out, because I want my graphic novel to be graphic novel size. And CreateSpace is how I published my first novel, like regular novel, but they don't have the size of a comic book. They just don't do it. Not without limiting how well you can distribute it. Okay. Now, let's have a look here. Okay. Cool. I'll make sure to hit that link before I close out the page so I can have a closer look at that. But that's the plan. Now, it's to pass... Okay, to Topastic. I did say that wrong. I don't have my glasses on. Is that only digital, or is that digital and print? Just curious. Actually, I guess I could just take a quick look at it. Won't hurt anything. It didn't hurt anything at all. All right. Oh, wow. 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 I really gotta get better at what I do. Man. Oh, yeah. Okay. Star. Oh, yeah. Save in favorites bar. Oh, yeah. That's gonna happen. That's cool. I'll be one of the peanut gallery. It doesn't matter. Like, just the idea that that place exists in that fashion, it might be slow motion to get people to see my particular stuff, but I'll see other people's stuff as well. And that, just a brief little quick section I looked just now, like, I'm gonna have some, oh wow, that looked like a cool place to even hang out. Like, I'm gonna go take a look at that again. Wow, that was dope. Yeah, I recently moved to the East Coast, so I don't have my bearings yet as far as the independent comic book stuff. Like, on the West Coast, I could go to a bunch of different comic book shops and sell my wares if I needed to and that kind of thing. But out here, I haven't even seen a comic book shop in my area. I'm sure they're out here, though. I gotta just do some legwork. okay, now I want to paint this tonight because I'm just curious. Gosh. Okay, but before I do that, let's see here. What is that? What layer is that? Unimportant layer. All right, let's get rid of this one now for now. Oh, okay. All right. Not terrible. Okay, but let's get up here and go here. Give me one more there. Fill up to about 70 or so. There we go. I have an ensemble cast of four characters here. My placeholder scene that I switched to when I left away from Key, that's actually like the process of creating the special edition cover, and it's kind of a take on the Empire Records movie poster, because I just like that poster a whole lot, and I just, for some reason, it came to mind when I was thinking about my drawing the cover, and so I used the poses sort of. The book is way less funny than that. But the story centers on sort of, I guess, two characters. One character who is the quote-unquote Superman of the story, without being such a Mary Sue about it. And then the other character is more central to this particular arc of stories, the 12 issues. It's more about her in the immediate sense, where he is the long-term protagonist. Let's see here. Okay. In this picture I'm working on, that's her on the right. That's Fiona. And that's her partner, Simon. I'm not a huge Alan Moore fan. I mean, I don't think he's not good, but I don't always think he's the greatest, you know. A lot of people think he's like the greatest ever, and I'm more of a Gail Simone is the greatest ever kind of person, you know. But I do appreciate the fact that he keeps his, I guess, critique of comics to something like, it's at a manageable level where it doesn't get away with his ability to tell a story, where other writers are so busy trying to prove a point that they kind of miss the point, you know. And so I felt like, instead of that, when it comes to my own art, instead of trying to prove a point so much as explain why I'm doing things a certain way, the idea is to like have a different take on maybe somewhat traditional stories and ideas, and that's more in keeping than it's, so it's less of a critique and more of a, well, let's look at Superman like this, let's look at Batman like this. Not so much Batman, I kind of leave Batman alone a lot, but it's just the standard tropes of comic book storytelling I try and kind of leave to the professionals, and instead go, well, if I had the chance to do it all over again, you know, what would I do differently? And that's what New World Chronicles, which is the overarching story, is about. If I had the chance to do it all over again, if Stan Lee and the original publisher of Marvel Comics were sitting down and they knew they were going to make a comic book universe, you know, a universe, and they were going to go for 70 to 80 years, if the guys who started DC Comics way back when knew that Batman and Superman were going to live in the same world together, there's going to be this big thing, this big universe of characters, what would they do differently to set that up, to set the groundwork? And so that's kind of the idea behind New World Chronicles. As opposed to, I think that I can do this better than, say, blank, which I don't know who I could say that about. Well, I probably have a couple opinions there, here and there, but I'm gonna let that go. I'm just gonna let that go.
Man,
I've been going for an hour already. Time goes by so fast when you're just kind of doing your thing. I think I'll finish my flowers and maybe do some more just base colors so that they're on there. And then I'm going to call it. But then again, maybe not. We'll see how it goes.
We'll be right back.
That music happened. Totally happened. Just mind my own business and that music played. It was amazing. Thank you. I really like this song. I'm always glad when it plays. Short though. All right, let's have a look at this. Okay. Oh, starting to fade a little bit. Almost there though. Wait a second. Guy's gonna be under here. Okay. Oh wait, nope. Can't do it that way yet. Well, I could, yeah. Thank you. I'm putting a little yellow on the flower heads, but it's like these are just flat colors that are gonna be primaries, and once I start to work with the rest of the image and come back and do more depth and stuff, I want to add a little, couple different more colors to the purple leaves or violet leaves, so they'll be a little bit multicolored. Like I might put a little blue in the center, you know, little strips of blue. Also, there can be some flecks of dark red in these yellow kind of bulbs, and then I'll be able to lighten the tree. I want to lighten the tree trunk with like a nice light green and maybe some brown splotches. So this is far from being done, but it's a good place to stop. Let's see our whole image. Have a quick look. Tiny tree, the grand scheme of things. So there's our tree. It's flowered. It's a little too bulbous, but you know, that might end up being for the best. Let's put our background layer in there for our roughs and have a look. Okay, so there'll be a whole lot going on in the image anyway, so maybe I don't need to worry too much about that one tree in that one scene. It'll work out. That bush is gonna be another one of those all day things. But there'll be more tree action tomorrow. I actually also might... No, like I said, I'm gonna leave the plant life for the live show. I might start coloring my heroes on this page or another page tomorrow. Tomorrow's already here, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. So I'm gonna stop the recording here as normal. I'm gonna save. Everyone wants to save way more than I do. Way more than I do. I'm one power outage away from being super pissed. Here we go. Back to our landing page. And wow, gosh, 11:30 to 1 o'clock in the morning. This is one of the longer sessions I've done. So tomorrow, I'm not sure how long it'll be. But gosh. What happened here? I mean, the delay can't be that bad. What's going on? Gosh. Oh, okay. So eventually it turned to the right page, but man, that thing is taking forever. I think it froze. Did my Photoshop freeze? Oh, it's like it did. It's not moving anymore. Oh well. I'm calling it a night, folks. And I will see you around next time.